just want you to see us, if you can, see the overcast that we got going on. You can't really tell, but if you look to the left in the distance, you can kind of see it. I think the camera filters are kind of blurring it out, and it's going to tip over.
In a 6-3 decision, the justices rejected a legal theory.
Something to put this fucking on.
This guy's trucking in this semi, fucking 64 miles an hour. I just want to draft off him and get my gas mileage up. Use his energy to push the air out of my way.
Region. Learn more at joycefdn.org and the Annie E. Casey Foundation. This is All Things Considered from NPR News. I'm Ari Shapiro.
And I'm Juana Summers. In a few minutes, we'll have a report from just outside Washington, D.C. proper at the Maryland home of Representative Jamie Raskin. He is on the mend after intensive cancer treatment and weighing what's next for his career. But we start this hour with news from the U.S. Supreme Court. Today, it repudiated the most extreme form of a controversial legal theory that would have radically reshaped the way American elections are conducted. It would have given state legislatures virtually unchecked power to decide election rules. NPR legal affairs correspondent Nina Totenberg reports.
At issue in the case was a decision by the North Carolina Supreme Court holding that the state legislature had violated state constitutional provisions barring partisan gerrymanders. The state court ultimately drew new district lines for the 2020 election, and the GOP-dominated state legislature appealed to the Supreme Court, advancing a relatively